The latest news and weather each weekday on Noonbreak.
Good morning. This is the first edition for Wednesday, September 23rd. I'm Bob Carrington. Two firemen were killed last night fighting a fire in the Willoughby Towers, an office building on South Michigan. The victims were not immediately identified. The fire started in an elevator between the 24th and 25th floors. First reports indicated the two firemen who were killed were on top of an elevator when the cable snapped, plunging the elevator 16 floors. At least five other firemen and a woman suffered burns or were overcome by smoke. Mayor Byrne said the city will buy two-way radios for all city firemen in the hopes that better communications will help avert similar tragic accidents. No serious injuries were reported last night when a freight train ran into some support beams as it sought to go under the Well Street Bridge at the Merchandise Mart. That section of Well Street is now blocked off to all traffic, and CTA service on the Ravenswood line is being rerouted. More now from John Quinones.
It happened at around 7:15 this evening. An eastbound northwestern freight train carrying newsprint hit the wooden and steel support beams underneath Well Street. Emergency crews rushed to the scene. Traffic was blocked off in the area around the Merchandise Mart.
A northwestern railroad train en route to the paper docks over to the east of here did not clear the supports for the Well Street Bridge, and it knocked those supports out. You can see the car here and the pieces of steel that the car dragged with it. As a result of that, Well Street and our Ravenswood elevated are both shut down.
Mayor Byrne arrived on the scene about an hour after the accident and looked over the twisted rails and support beams. She left after a 15-minute inspection. Streets and sanitation officials and workmen then began their inspection, drawing up alternative plans for traffic flow in the area tonight and tomorrow morning.
Well, streets and sanitation is blocking off all of the streets around here, posting no parking signs, and we're going to work with the CTA to detour all the bus traffic. We can't allow traffic on the street or the L tracks to go over until we get this, as I understand it, from the all of the parties concerned, this is shored up properly.
The CTA says shuttle buses will carry Ravenswood riders into the loop this morning. The Evanston Express will follow the Howard Line subway route. Striking teachers in Elgin have reached a tentative contract settlement and are expected back in the classes today. Details of the two-year pact were not revealed. The agreement was reached last night in an Elgin courtroom. Four union officials who were jailed for defying a back-to-work order have been released. In New York, Secretary of State Haig meets with Soviet Foreign Minister Gromyko at the United Nations today. They'll discuss restraints on deployment of missiles in Europe. On the eve of that session, President Reagan sent Soviet President Brezhnev a letter saying that the United States is prepared to establish a framework of mutual respect with the Soviet Union. And Gromyko expressed, when he addressed the General Assembly at the United Nations, this attitude. Robert Pierpoint has more.
Gromyko's tone was unusually hostile toward the United States. He accused the Reagan administration of trying to gain military superiority over the Soviet Union and of trying to dominate the world. The Soviet leader then issued this veiled threat.
Hostile, criminal intrigues against Cuba on the part of the United States, which have of late been stepped up, must cease.
At one point, Gromyko mocked President Reagan's contention that the world is seeing the sunset of Soviet-style socialism, calling this an enviable gift of imagination. He went on to condemn the Pentagon's plans for a new U.S. military buildup.
The whipping up of the arms race is madness. The present balance of military power is fully in line with the interests of peace and international stability.
Finally, in an obvious bid for the anti-nuclear vote around the world, Gromyko proposed a UN resolution declaring that the first use of nuclear weapons be the gravest crime against humanity. Afterward, a spokesman gave Secretary of State Haig's reaction to Gromyko's speech.
We view it as a disappointing speech. We found it extremely defensive in tone. It was was marked by stale rhetoric and an absence of constructive proposals on any item of concern to the international community.
Secretary Haig met today with the foreign minister of Poland just before Gromyko accused the United States of trying to shake loose the foundations of the Polish socialist state. Haig reportedly stressed that the U.S. will not interfere in Poland's internal affairs and expects all others to follow the same rule.
Congressional Democrats are asking for equal time to answer President Reagan. The president talks to the nation Thursday at 8 p.m. Central Time on proposed new budget cuts. Channel 2 will carry the address live.
They're moving out. The last trail drive of the 1981 Toyota trucks is underway. It's the end of a great year, so now's the time to cook up your year-end deal on a total economy Toyota truck. Your Toyota dealer has a limited selection of America's best-selling small trucks, even fuel-thrifty diesels. Prices may never be lower. And we even have some cars.
Oh, oh, what a feeling to deal. Toyota.
And see your Toyota dealer fast, partner.
Remember your very first day at school? The best things about it for me were seeing Mom when I got out and making Kool-Aid when we got home. It was the perfect after-school treat.
Still is. Compare it to soda. Including my sugar, Kool-Aid unsweetens about one-third the price. Has vitamin C, and that fruity taste is still in a class by itself.
You loved it as a kid. You trust it as a mother. Kool-Aid brand unsweetened soft drink mix.
The taste of Sheraton.
You're gonna love every inch of the place. We've got taste.
Sheraton, you've got taste.
We've got style.
For a great hotel in the center of things, call 800-325-3535.
We've got taste.
A Cook County grand jury has indicted a Southside man in the rape of a woman who was attacked as she was picking up her auto in a city parking garage at 506 North Rush. He's Harry Miller of 9705 South Hoxie, who's charged with rape, battery, robbery...